Hello, everyone. Before I speak about Josh, I want to speak directly to all of you. I want to say thank you. Thank you for showing that amidst divisive times, we can still come together. What a beautiful experience it has been to see this community become one in support of the ones who choose every day to protect us, even though most of us don't deserve it. Josh, or Joshy, as you hated when I called you. We met over 15 years ago in the Mooresville ROTC high school program. And to tell you the truth, we hated each other when we first met. We argued constantly, but like the plot of a bad buddy cop comedy movie, we came together through drill meets, field trips, and a lot of late nights driving miles around a town with nothing to do. We developed a bond and a group of friends that would make even the Jedi jealous. When our group grew up and spread across the country, Josh never missed a beat. As if he had a monthly reminder set on his phone, you would receive a "How's things?" text, accompanied by some of the funniest memes and videos the internet had to offer. When you first meet Josh, he is hard to gauge. He is stern, steadfast, and serious. It's not until you talk about music, comic books, working out, or his family that you get the chance to experience one of the most amazing souls this planet has to offer. See, as big as Josh is, he had the ability to make the world feel small. When he spoke to you, all he did was listen. He is there, present in the moment, and attentive to what you're saying. And if you needed the shirt from his back, it would be off of his body before you were done asking the question. When I was 20, my family lost our home. And I was with Josh when I got that phone call that my mom was on the street with my dog and a shopping cart full of her stuff. Josh didn't just drop me off, he stayed. He spent 8 to 10 hours making sure my family's things were taken care of and transferred to a storage unit with care. He held my little sister as she cried and watched her life be dismantled room by room. Then, after lifting things and working all day, he didn't hesitate to jump in the car with me at 11 p.m. to drive my mom to New York. But that's just who Josh was, not just with friends and family, but with everybody. Josh gave my friends and I the most valuable gift you can give somebody, time. 7,889,400. That's how many minutes we got over 15 years to watch our best friend grow and create the life we always talked about on those late night drives. Mr. and Mrs. Eyer, thank you so much for raising such an amazing man and for allowing us to leave construction cones in your garage at 2 a.m. We got to watch him start not one, but two careers. We got to watch him change lives around the globe with nothing more than his personality. We got to watch him smile and laugh more than most did. Even though we experienced so many smiles, none of them pierced through the ambient noise of life like when he met the love of his life in a college. I say in because Josh squatted there for 8 months before taking a class. Ashley, I need to thank you in front of the world for giving Josh a family and giving me the selfish privilege of watching you live your lives together. But most importantly, thank you for giving us Andrew, a spinning image of Josh from head to toe. I remember the excitement we shared when he told me he was having a son. We talked about things like what sports he would play and making sure he knew the difference between Marvel and DC comic characters. We disagreed on some things in that element, like how Josh thought Batman would always beat Superman in a fight. Of all the titles that he held, Dad was the one that meant the most to him, as is evident in every single picture of him and his family Josh took full advantage of the experience he was blessed to share with his wife and son. When he spoke about them, you could hear his smile through the phone. I could go on for hours talking about the amazing man, friend, son, brother, and husband he was. But I can hear him telling me to hurry up, it's getting old. So I want to leave you with this. We spend our entire lives writing this book, the book of our lives, filling the pages with experiences of love, pain, fear, and happiness. And when our loved ones pass, we treat it like the end of their story. Instead, I urge you to honor the pages. Use your memories as a bookmark and relive those moments as many times as you can. Josh's book is not finished, as he was a man of faith. He's just writing his next chapter in the presence of the Lord. And when we see him again, he'll have even more smiles and stories to share with us. So today, May 3rd, remember Josh, the man he was and the family he loved so dearly. But in honor of my best friend, when you wake up tomorrow, hear him loud and clear when he says, "May the 4th be with you." We all experience loss, but losing family you choose is the hardest thing I've had to experience. After the service, take out your phones and send your own how's things text to the people you love and haven't spoken to in a while. As one who received them so regularly, they'll mean more than you can ever imagine to the person on the other side. Josh, just like we used to end our texts, I love you, brother. I got your back forever. Thank you for letting me be in so many chapters of your best-selling book.